One of the best new features to come from Airtable in recent weeks has been the record templates. And we did a video on this not too long ago when it first came out, but one of the questions we keep getting asked is, how do I use this with relative dates? So in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down for you not only how to use record templates, but also how to use it with relative dates and how you can go even deeper by including it within your interfaces so that people who are accessing your database through an interface can use your record templates. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no code. In this video, we're gonna be breaking down one of our favorite no code tools, Airtable, and we're gonna be showing how you can leverage record templates, specifically focusing on relative dates and including record templates inside of an interface. But before we get into the heart of this, let me first invite you to join me for a free training. If you are newer to Airtable, or if you've been using it for a bit and you want to make sure you're unlocking its full potential, well then, my friend, you will greatly benefit from our Airtable Crash Course. It's entirely free. You can sign up at garethpronovost.com/airtable-crash-course. That link will be wherever you found this video. Go ahead and get signed up so that you are not leaving anything on the table when it comes to unlocking the full potential of Airtable. That crash course will be delivered to your inbox over the series of about a week and a half, and you will be on your way to Airtable mastery. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this. We've got to start looking at the record template. So I have a really simple database design for us. So let's go ahead and hop on in. And I've already started by building all of this out. We're gonna go step by step so that you can see how to add a new template, how to include the relative dates, and then how to add that template to record creation inside of an interface. Let's go one step at a time. First, we have to break down our setup. Here I have projects and tasks. Nothing too complicated here. We create a new project, and a project has a type. And then we have a start date, an estimated end date, and then a link to tasks. So when we create a new project, we want to automatically create those tasks as well. And the tasks will be dependent on the type of project. So if we create project type one, whatever the heck that is, then maybe we only have one task. So you can see here, well, we created a bunch of extra tasks that we wouldn't have needed. And so we want to make sure that we create a template here so that when we create a new project of type one, it also automatically creates the task for project type one. Now, similarly, if we are doing project type two, well, then we want to create two tasks for that. So let's flip on over into our tasks and take a look at what we have here. So on our tasks, we have a formula here in the primary field, which I will come back to. I want to focus on the task name, which is 1, 2, 3, you know, pretty simple. Then we are linking to the project. We assign the task to someone. The project has a start date. This is looked up. So this is a lookup field where we are saying, hey, I know what project this is assigned to. What's the start date that lives in that project? And this is really just here for reference. What I care about here is the due date of the task. And what we're going to be focusing on is creating this due date relative to the start date. So let's take a look at how we can build a template for this. Up here in the right corner, upper right corner, we click on Tools and we come down to Record Templates. Now I've already added two templates here, so let's drill into them really quickly. The first one is New Project Type 1. And you'll notice that when I create this, basically what I'm saying is this particular template will create a new project with anything that I've assigned here, and also will create any of the linked or associated records. Now I do wanna highlight that we can set a bunch of rules for what is being created here. So when we create this particular template, this is saying, again, a project of type one, we only have one task that we wanna create with that type of project. So over here, our new task, we give it a name, we assign a user to it, and I wanna also highlight that the user can be relative here. We can assign someone so that every single time this template is run or is created, it always gets assigned to Gareth, or we can assign it to the current user so that it's relative. Whoever it is that's accessing and implementing the template would then have this assigned to them. So that's great, we have some flexibility there. Now, here we have the due date. And as you can see here, we have a relative due date established. A certain number of days, either before or after another date that has already existed in this template. So for us, we are working with dates that are relative to the project. So it's important to understand the hierarchy. So in our example, we are first creating the project record, and we are assigning a start date here where we have brought in the current date. Now, I also want to highlight that we have an estimated end date, but as you see here, at this top level, we can only bring in the current date. So any other calculations that we do, any other relative dates, will be relative to whatever dates we have in the project. So later on, a layer deeper, when we create our tasks, the dates here will be relative to dates that exist in the project record. So when we establish this date here inside of our task, what we're doing is we are given the option to refer to dates in the project. So here we could assign this relative to the estimated end date. Now, of course, in our example, we don't have a date here, so we wouldn't want to include that. But we could also include the start date or the current date again. But again, here we are within the relative date setting, and it only applies a layer deep inside of our template. We cannot access relative dates other than the current date at the project level, only when we go a layer deeper inside of our template. So let's really quickly just build one of these for ourselves. We have three different types of projects. If I flip back into projects, we have type one and type two, and I currently have two templates. One template for type one, one template for type two. Let's build a third one. So I will say new template, and what am I going to create? Well, again, the top level here is that project level. So I'm going to create a new project. And here's where I can start typing whatever the project is gonna be. Now, this is gonna change every time, the name of the project. So I'm not gonna save something here inside of the template, but I do want to link out to some tasks. So what tasks? Well, I wanna create task one, and I'll assign this to the current user. And the due date here will be a relative date, which let's say is 3 days after the current date or the start date of the project. In either case, it'll be the same because I'll actually go back into the project and make sure that the start date of the project is today's date. Let's go ahead and save this one up. Now I can assign additional tasks. Since this is type three, let's imagine it also has three types of tasks. So I'll create another and another. Here is my task two. Let's go ahead and drill in here. Again, assign this to the current user relative, let's say 7 days after the current date. And we'll go ahead and save that. And then the last one here will be task three. Again, assign that to the current user. And one more time, I could use an absolute date so that it's always the same date. But in our example, I'm focusing on relative dates. So let's go 9 days after the current date. So let's go ahead and save that up. And from here, I need to make sure I also save my changes to the project itself. So I've created my tasks, but I also want to assign the project type. This is going to be our template for type three. So I always want it to be that. And as I mentioned, the start date of the project will be the current date. So that's the only relative date that I can access as a reminder at the top level. So once I'm happy with this, last piece would be to rename it. So I'll select right here and rename this. I'll call this project, new project. And let's go ahead and make sure we bring in type three, and we should be good with that. So I'll exit out. Now I have three different template types. So take this out for a spin real quick. If I wanted to just create a new project here, inside of here, I can say add a project. Because I've already brought in my templates, it gives me the option to just, hey, create one record or create something from a template. I will assign type three here, which automatically creates a new project. It knows it's gonna be a type three project. And of course, that is also going to link to three different tasks, which we see right here. Those tasks will be relative in date compared to today. So we see that as of filming, it is June 16th. And so all of the dates on those tasks will be relative to the start date of the project. So let me go ahead and name this project now that it's been created. This will be project five. And I can drill into my tasks table, drill into project five here. Where is it? Still coming in. All right, moved down to the bottom. And I can check my dates. Now remember, we're looking up that project start date, and in here we have relative to the start date. So the first one, if we drill into our project here, the first one was 3 days after, the next task is 7, and then the final task is 9 days after. So if we were to take a look at this, from the 16th, we have 3 days after, excluding weekends. So I count 1, 2, 3. That's how we get our relative date. Here on the 27th, if you recall, 7 days after. So we can count 5 days here, Monday through Friday, 6 and 7, and that's it. Those are our 7 days, etc. Now, I do want to point out that we don't have to exclude weekends if we don't want to. Inside of the template itself, when we were establishing that relative date, we have the option to edit the settings here. So we can turn it off so that we're actually counting Saturdays and Sundays as well. But for our example here, I'm going to assume we're closed on the weekends, and I'll keep this toggled on. If you want to make any changes though, you just toggle it off, update, and now your dates will include counts for the weekend days as well. So that's it for setting up your relative dates. Now let's dive just a little bit deeper and look at interfaces. I've already built an interface actually for us here. And inside of this interface, I've allowed us to add a new project. If you're new to interfaces, where we start with this is to edit our interface. And here on this element, on the right-hand side, we want to make sure that we have allowed users to create new projects. This is toggled on. Now beyond that, come on down and you see the record template options. Because we've built templates for the projects, and this right here is allowing us to create a new project. Because those two things are true, we can now create new projects from a template inside of our interface. So here I've already synced it up so that we can create new projects from templates either using type 1 or type 2. But we just built type 3. In order to include it here, we need to say add a template from projects. And here's our new one, new project type 3. There we go. Now I also have the option here to say the only way to create new projects is to create through a template. So I've toggled this on as well. You make the choice that makes the most sense for your example. And once we're happy with these changes, we publish this interface. Anybody now who has access to the interface can create a new project or select one from the list. In our example, let's say I want to create project 6. I hit this right here and it's going to ask me what template type I want to use. If I use type 3, I will create 3 tasks that are assigned to this project with relative dates to today, again, which is June 16th as of recording. So I'll make that selection, and right here I'll name this, let's call it project 6, I think is where we are, project 6. You notice that it by default is going to be type 3 because that's what we're making, and I say create. It now creates project 6 with the 3 extra pieces here. You see the 3 tasks with the appropriate dates relative to the date of creation. I know we unpacked a lot in this video and went kind of fast, so if you have questions or something wasn't answered, please be sure to drop the question below. And in the meantime, keep on building.